I did some research online on what to do when you run into a ghost. So number one, they said wear tight clothes so the ghost can't get in on you. So I'm wearing my armor, very tight, keeping it tight. And then I'm a good religious boy. So one thing I bring with me is the Lord is my co-pilot. So one of those ghosts come, I'm just going to start going like this. But I got to change out of my boots and some tennis so I can run. These boots are just going to be a little too tough to run in. So in case I need a quick escape, that's what I'm going to do. I have a little bit more spirits to lift the spirits so I can fight the spirits. And we're on our way.
I don't know. Just, it's scary, man. I don't know what I should be thinking. It's just scary. I'm hoping I come out alive.
But tonight's on a different level. I'm afraid, so. Guys are going to get me into a dark room or into a dark building, and who knows what's going to happen. Hopefully they stick around and give me a ride home, because I'm not so sure they will. In any event, I trust them, and I guess we'll keep our fingers crossed.
So we're ready to go ghost hunting. They're all afraid. I want to see something. I want to see a ghost.
Hoping for the best tonight. You're screaming, it's probably me. I'm okay with that. So we'll see you inside.
I'm afraid of the ghost. I hear it likes the girls. I'm afraid of the ghost.
Woman, we'll see. You'll see it on the tour, but it's a woman seen in the window, and she appears in the window. People see it as they pass by. So I'm going to get one more camera set up downstairs, possibly one more.
Who can you call?
I'll be right by the sign.
Kevin, is this your room?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah? Okay.
Absolutely. Take a memo, take a note, do it, and just be safe.
I had to meet a psychiatrist here at 8 a.m. on a Saturday morning, which is not, at that time, long time ago, the best time for me to be up and meeting someone. So I got here early. He wanted bagels and he wanted coffee, and, you know, so we provided that. I came in, unlocked the back door, all right, and this is before voicemail. My answering machine was beeping in my secretary's room up the stairs here. Well, sure enough, I walked up the back steps to see him, thinking the psychiatrist was going to cancel, because, you know, I went through all this trouble. I got coffee, I got bagels, it's 8 a.m. on a Saturday morning, and it was somebody who wanted to make an appointment, no big deal. So right behind her office is the restroom. I had to go to the bathroom, so I cut around the corner and I went to go into the bathroom, and there was a man standing there looking in the mirror, and I thought, oh, was that back door locked? Did I leave that? Was that alarm on? Was this one of my therapists? Who's working here on a Saturday morning? Why are they here? And as I went to focus on who it was to say, oh, Tom, I didn't know you were here, you know, as I focused, it dissipated. As I felt my eyes focus. Instead of saying, oh, I didn't know you were here, I said, oh, neat. Because it was like, whoa. Never had that happen before, you know, and this was like, you know, a Saturday morning. You know. So I went to the phone, called my wife to tell her what happened, and I said, Kathy, I just saw a ghost. And she said, Adam, don't tell people that. You're a psychologist. And I thought, well, okay. And I didn't for a while. But then I had a friend who came in, and she, on a Friday the 13th, insisted that she go around the house and take photographs. And so she did. One of the photographs that she took was in the third floor west room, and there was an apparition.
We just ask that you guys do not provoke anything here. The only provoker here should be me, or... if at all, Adam.
I wear my dad's dog tags. I went inside and they fell off. I've never taken them off, they broke.
I have seen the white lady on more than one occasion. I've thought that this was a patient waiting for me. I thought I was already done for the day. It even got to the point where I'd look and see the person go back to my secretary and say, "Who's left? I thought I was done." And she'd walk back with me and there's nobody there. I came up the back stairs over here, came around here to go use the restroom, and there was a guy standing right there at that sink looking in the mirror. He had on dark clothes, he had dark hair, and that's all I saw, because when I went to visualize him, he just dissipated as I looked from the top down.
I don't want to look around too much, like I'm going to see something. What the? I feel calm.
We were here with our backs to each other in a circle. We saw a dark shadow come out of this room and go down into the floor. All right?
Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah.
Right there.
And consequently, at that same time, we were in the synchronicity of it all, the people in the basement heard something pretty dark and on their EVP.
Fear nothing.
What? Are you still cold?
It's gone.
It is gone, yeah.
I swear to God, I didn't touch you.
Dude, I was holding the truck. You're probably mad. It's the kid.
Why don't you put the truck back where it should be?
Do you like playing in the corner?
I got chilled like you.
See, it's
you.
Because
you just touched me.
I didn't touch you. I swear on my kids that I didn't touch you. And I would not swear on my kids.
If there's anybody down in the basement, would you like to communicate with us? We come here good spirit. We ask that you make a noise or make yourself known by speaking to us.
Come on, 55.8, and I'll walk out of here.
Just trying to really stay on it.
You're trying real hard. 55.8. Either 55.8 or show us your face. Can you do that?
Don't be afraid. You were seeing shape of your face in that mirror.
Oh, it's going up to 55.8.
Did it go?
It's starting to blink,
it's
yeah.
Flickering. It's going 7.8, 7.8, 7.8, 7.8.
Okay.
7, 8. Yep, 5.5.7.8.
I'll walk away.
8.8.8. Keeps flickering at 8.
Wow.
Okay, we're going to leave you alone, okay?
Take a picture of that.
Enjoy your shower. We're leaving.
Oh my God.
You missed that, dude.
There you go.
In this room?
Yeah. Is there something in it?
Yeah. It just told us to leave.
Did Billy told you?
Don't go in there. He just told us to leave. Look. Oh my God. And we told him where to go on the meter, and it went up there. And I said, "You want us to leave? Go to 56.
You see?
It went up. We had to leave.
Way too.
how to do it. Let's get some Southern in your pride. Get some Georgia on your mind. Keep you rolling with the tides. Gonna get you, don't you fight. Put some y'all in your talk. Put some twang in your rock. If you're gonna be mine, gotta get you, gotta get you. Put some y'all in your talk. Put some twang in your rock. If you're gonna